You mentioned your father, and we were saying that we're here to know the person, the woman behind the scientist. I don't know how many people hear Dr. Swaminathan and immediately know that you're the daughter of the famed MS Swaminathan, who is being invoked even today. There we can see some pictures on the screen with Soumya with her father, the architect of India's agricultural program, the Green Revolution, and being invoked today as farmers protest now for weeks altogether. They all want the Swaminathan panel to be implemented. He's a great man. What was it like to be his daughter, Soumya?
Yes, I mean, I think looking back again, there were probably much more positives than negatives of growing up in a household where my father was already a well-recognized international scientist. And so we had the opportunity to meet scientists from all over the world who would visit the Indian Agricultural Research Institute. And we got to hear, and we were young then, but they were Nobel laureates. There were people like Sir C.V. Raman who came and stayed at home. And we got to hear from really wise people. At the same time, my father always made it a point to take us on his field visits. So I've gone to many villages in Punjab and Haryana where he was working with the farmers. And in fact, very often on the weekend, we would drive out and we would sit and talk with farmers. And that's where I think I learned that you need to talk to people. You need to talk to the people you're trying to actually serve, or the end users of your products. You know, the new seeds that he was trying to create and so on. And at the same time, my mother worked with migrant labor. She worked with an organization called Mobile Creches, which set up creches for young children. So I've been to many of the construction sites with her and seen how babies are were not taken care of until these creches were built and for these women. So my parents both made sure that we had exposure, even though we lived a privileged life, relatively, with everything we could ask for, on a government salary, of course, but we never felt, the lack of anything. We were always very conscious that there were many, many people in India who were not so fortunate. And I think that also had a deep impression on me growing up.